Very nice playing, brava, brava, both of you. So, very nice. Now, okay, if you're playing Beethoven and classical music, I would say there are some elements very important. Of course, dynamics.
Yes.
And I would say also articulation. Here and there, I think you could work more with your right hand for expression and less with your left hand, particularly because these are sonatas for violin and piano, or maybe actually, if you take it correctly, these are sonatas for clavier and violin.
Yes.
Meaning you're equally important. Mm-hmm. If you want to make music with a pianist, I think you have to think a little bit more like a pianist, meaning your spiccatos can be shorter, because if you listen well to how your colleague is playing, spiccatos on the piano, they're much shorter and much more articulated than you do on the violin. So okay. I suggest you try to play the piano on the violin.
Okay.
Okay. I think this is the most important message that I have for you. Try to imitate much more the sound and the articulation of the pianist.
Okay.
Whatever pianist you play with, they will always articulate sharper than you do when you play a solo violin concerto. So try to, we say, go into the skin of the pianist. Try to mentally think, how does a pianist articulate? And try to imitate that on the violin. Now, another thing is, this is of course a very difficult beginning. Very difficult for ensemble technical reasons. Yes. There's no way as a violinist you can just sort of go like, go and start playing and then just pray that it will be together. The only way to start this piece well is if the two of you, you and whoever is your pianist that you're playing the piece with, breathe together and then start together. There is no hierarchy. It's not the pianist giving it to the violinist. It's not the violinist giving it to the pianist. You have to actually breathe together in the spirit of the music and then start. Meaning, at least you'll have to look at each other.
Yeah.
You want to give it a try?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, now I would like, I'm so sorry, I forgot the name of the pianist.
Veneta.
Could you please play once the first phrase for Arta, and then she can maybe imitate how you play. So you have to I think more vertically.
Okay, yes.
So just forget you have a bow. You just go like a jumping animal. Okay? That was so much better. The only thing I don't like so much is how you play your sforzato. I think, still think of being a pianist. Ba-dum. I think you need a fast accent there. And you can't take so much time, particularly not in bar four. There's no way you can take time there. It has to be a quick accent, a quick bow, and then try it once more and try not to sit so long on these sforzatos.
Okay.
They are part of the music. It's not like I'm playing music in a pulse. And then you do para. Totally out of context.
Okay?
Another suggestion in which you will move a little closer to piano playing, which is always at the end of a slur. And when you have an eighth note after that that has a dot, think that the last note under the slur already has a dot. So you have two dots. So every time when you have that, you don't have to write it because it's always the same. You'll have to write it about 300 times if you want to write it. Always the last note under the slur has a dot. Always.
Okay.
And also, don't be in a hurry. Here you can play the violin. Okay? Here you don't have to be a pianist.
Okay.
You want to start there, bar 12?
Yes.
Or bar 13, it doesn't matter. Bar 12 or 13. Okay, very good. I love your sound. You have a very nice, you have a very rich sound. It's really amazing. I can even hear it here in Amsterdam, even on the laptop. Okay, now, for instance, the up bar before 27, you have repeating notes. A pianist would never play. He has to lift the finger and repeat. So you have to play short also. You have to speak more. Not.
Okay.
Okay. So you can start a few bars before wherever.
Yeah,
probably. Okay, now here, again, you're not really paying attention to the pianist. You're running away like a running horse. And you're not really making music with your lovely pianist. So try not to run away so much. And then be conscious that the second one you have together. It usually is enough when you think of, I have to take her by the hand so we walk through that door together. If you just go, you push her through and one of you might fall. That's not really nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, try this, to be more conscious of your togetherness.
From where? Maybe from A?
Bar 28? Maybe you really have to put one foot on the brake or hold your horse back just for one note to make sure you actually establish this togetherness. Once more, same place. Okay, that was already better. Try it once more. This is the idea. It's very good. Okay. Now you put a little break. It's very nice also what you did. Like this A, I can have a tiny little bit extra length before this jump. And then maybe before the fortissimo again, just a little moment to place the fortissimo. Okay. Just to think of taking your partner with you. Start this fortissimo to establish it, the togetherness. Same place. Okay, start there. 32 is upbeat. Yeah. Okay, I don't hear the difference between forte and fortissimo. How are you going to solve that? Maybe the fortissimo can have a little accent. How do you suggest that you can play louder on a legato than you did before on the détaché? I think maybe it's physically not possible to play louder, but you can suggest that you play louder by putting an accent on the fortissimo. And then maybe.
Again?
Yeah. Okay, now, Arta, you're really rushing. You make it very hard for your partner to be together with you. If you ever have to play a Beethoven sonata on like Queen Elizabeth competition or something like that, all the jury is looking for is your ensemble playing. Because Everyone can play a Beethoven sonata. But what makes it the true art, the music making, is making music together. And you have to think of how you phrase and how you articulate, really considering the piano playing. So try once more, and don't just, you play very virtuoso accelerando, but your pianist doesn't do that. So you have to somehow find her in the middle. You can't be all that free because it doesn't sound classical anymore. Okay? Now find something in between. Passage. And you know what? I'm not sure if it's the computer, but I have the suspicion that you never play softer than mezzo piano. And I think the characteristic of Ludwig van Beethoven very much is the dynamic range. Mm-hmm. So I think the lyrical passages, you can, and the pianos, you can play softer. I think whenever you see a crescendo, start softer.
Okay.
And then you can make more crescendo. And then when you have a subito piano, take a little bit of time again to establish togetherness with your pianist. Mm-hmm. Okay, would you like to play the lyrical passage once more? Mm-hmm. Maybe from 35. That's very loud, very beautiful loud violin playing. But actually, I don't know where's the melody here? I think the melody is in the piano. Okay, so maybe you could consider playing more spiccato. Doesn't necessarily have to be so much softer, but if you play spiccato, although I would play mezzo forte, and more and shorter, much shorter, much more jumpy. Okay. And then the pianist can shine through, even though she's behind you. Okay? Okay, and then another thing, start the forte right from the forte, not the second 16th note. The high D already forte, okay?
Okay, yes.
Yeah. Maybe 47? Dun, tia, da, da, da. And now maybe not. Yeah?
Okay.
Here on the repeating notes, play again, play like ba, 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 piano vibrato. Is it totally not interesting here? The pianist also would never play piano. They simply can't. So There's no need for you. You have your moments. There are lyrical passages where you can put a beautiful sound. Here, it's totally inappropriate. You can start there. This is 53. Ah, play piano. Accent on the high A and not on the low D, because I hear like an appoggiatura. I hear padam instead of padam.
Okay, yes.
You could start there, which is 61. Okay, very good. One more thing. When you have, for instance, this place, just what you played net just now. Don't end like this.
Okay.
The last note, totally unimportant. Just let it evaporate. It's like...
Okay.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. And then... there, can you play really, really legato? It's very beautiful, it's very difficult, but I'm sure you can do it. That's why I ask it.
More bow?
Yes, the bow. why don't you start? Bum, ba, 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 da, ba, 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 53. Or 50, what is it, 60? Yeah, a little few bars before that.
Again from this?
Yeah.
Why not?
Okay.
Crescendo in the legato bar towards the middle of the bar. Yeah! Okay! Okay, now this is another place where I really don't feel any togetherness. I think actually you need to establish those sforzatos. Think of the pianist, the poor pianist who has to keep up with you. So every sforzato can take a tiny little bit more time. Bum, 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 bum. I'm exaggerating, but it's just a very, very little bit. You just place it together. It's hardly anything, it's very little. It's just this little bit of awareness of ensemble. Would you try that, please? Start at the trill Or start the scale once more. I like it very much when you went to the middle of the bar. 79. Sorry. Okay. Don't play longer. Don't play longer. Just play a tiny little bit later, but still short. Just accent, not long. Would you please try for me once? Just an accent, not a long line. Just one note loud, all the other notes soft, but nothing with length. Just loud, vertical, one note loud, all the other notes soft. Okay? Very good. One more thing. Give it a dot as well. Not. No pianist would ever play like that.
Yes.
So we on the violin, we have to really think like a pianist. Okay?
Again, the same place?
81, why not? Yeah. Do you speak German?
No.
Ooh, because I don't know. For suddenly, I don't know the name in. Okay, it doesn't matter. I didn't know the name in English. The short notes after the two. They're always late. This. Extra 16th, like you're losing time because you bring those two small notes too late. You have to place them earlier. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Okay. So
under the second ending. Okay, that's late. That was late. Three da di dam. Your bow? Just a very little articulation. Like. Yeah. You just need an articulation for the first short note, not both of them, just one. Just one articulation. Yeah, and then a little earlier. Little earlier. Okay, you don't feel it yet. Forget it. Forget it. Just bring it a little earlier. No articulation. Same place.
Yeah.
I'm not happy yet.
Thank you.
I do is I put a little accent on the E. You can practice once like this. Yeah, but it's too late. It's a little bit too late. Meaning, long note, the trill is too long. Maybe... forget about it. Sometimes, we even, with some conductors, we would even do this. Meaning you have to start a tiny little bit earlier with the short notes. Yeah.
So should I play separately?
No, you play your own bowing. It's just, I don't hear them clearly. They're basically a little bit too late and a little bit too fast. And I can't hear them in Amsterdam. Okay, let's see if together with the piano you're not retarding the music because of the trill and because of the short notes. Basically, the message is bring your short notes a little earlier. Only out of tune, but it's also much too loud. Because it's really, this is a very fragile place. Mm-hmm. And of course, everybody always plays this out of tune because it's second position, but what the fuck? Just should be in tune. But play soft, even though it's difficult, okay? Now, can I hear you without piano just once slowly? Once more and no articulation, just notes. This is the thing with Mozart and Beethoven. It's so easy, but it's so incredibly open that it's actually very hard to play it well. Yes. Okay, play once more. There's absolutely, you have no possibility to play out of tune with this because the piano has a perfect intonation. You have to match this. Once more, because already without the piano you're out, not really in tune. Okay, maybe once with the help of your dear colleague. Can you help her? Da dee dee da da. Yeah? Now I hear quite intonation in, do it once more, not faster than this, and listen really careful to the piano. Okay, so now, the thing is, a piano usually has a tempered intonation. Do you know what that is? Das wohl temperierte Klavier.
Yes.
Meaning you have to play sharps, flats, and flats sharp. And a big third has to be flat, and a small third has to be sharp. This is how a piano tuner tunes the instrument. Mm-hmm. We have, if we don't adjust to this, we sound out of tune. Mm-hmm. Okay, try once more. Now you learned, I think. Now you're hearing. Now you're hearing what's the difference. Okay, let's try again three bars before that from the, in tempo. See if it helped. I hope it helped. Okay. Once more. Can you really start the pianissimo much more careful, like you are caressing, like there's a little kitty, a little cat has just been born, and you're really touching it in the most velvetly soft way. Okay, practice this one also with the piano from the B. Much better already. So only the C sharp was sharp. Yeah, much better. Good. I think we have to go back again. Or shall we do the whole passage slowly? With music, but a little slower. What's the problem? So your A sharp is really way too sharp.
Okay.
Once more, slowly, and try to listen to the piano. So you can work this out later, okay, without me, but now you know it needs attention, okay?
Yes.
We go on. Maybe from 113? The last one? The same problems that we had in the beginning.
Yes.
So try to put into practice already now that we are in the recap. Try to remember what I told you.
Yes.
In the exposition of this piece, okay? That you have four dots in this bar. So the last note of the slur also has a dot. You get long, short, short, long, short, short. Can you start there? Crescendo up to the high D, and then you play piano again. Ba, 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 ba. Not way, 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 way. Yum, ba, ba, ba. Okay. So make more contrast between the legato and the spiccato. Mm-hmm. Okay? Interesting here, dun, dun, dun. He doesn't do what you would expect. You expect, but he does, mm-hmm. He does something really, totally unexpected. Can you bring that out more?
Yes.
Start 161. Are together. Did you hear they're not together? You are way quicker than the pianist, which means you're actually not taking her with you. Make sure your whole body radiates where you want to play the last two notes. At least if you don't feel it, then Show it.
So, from where we can...
Just stay in tempo and just wait a tiny little bit before the piano, but maybe not twice later, not bum bum, maybe bip bum 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 bum. Try just a few bars before, maybe the last six bars. Try once more. Yes, that was very nice. That was a very nice ending. I don't think we have much time left for the next movement. Did you prepare all the movements?
Yes.
Shall we just do a tiny little bit of the minuetto?
Yes.
No, just a little bit. Let's go back immediately because we have 5 minutes left or something. Okay, try to make really long line and really, really think where can you articulate. I would say in general, I would like you to place the 16th note a really earlier so you can play them a little broader. Da di 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 dum, not dan di di di. So the 16th notes are also in the slow spirit of this music. Da di 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 da di. Bring them, just bring them a little earlier so you can spread them out a little bit. Okay. Could you once more repeat this from the upbeat to bar 9 where you have the melody? Now, I like this very much. Take this much time. Like as if you were waiting for the pianist who's not ready. I think it's a very good idea to make that official. No hurry. Thank you. So again, he does something really weird. He does instead what you would expect. He does. See if you can bring it out a little more even. Meaning usually you need a tiny little bit of time if you want to bring something out. Start at the crescendo bar. Stop here because somebody else wants to play for me. Very good work. I hope you can take some of this with you in your violin musical journey. And hope to see you again.
Thank you very much.
Nice playing. Keep thinking of your poor pianist who has to follow you. No, she doesn't have to follow you. The task of a pianist is not to follow the violinist. You actually have to play together. That's the message, okay? Yeah. This is something you need to work on, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Very
Thank
well
you
played,
very
beautiful
much.
Sound. I enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Vielen Dank. Besser Deutsch.
Dankeschön.